basically the works are found objects, and they come from Southern Oregon and parts of Northern California. They were not only found by me, but by another elderly gentleman who is really into collecting wood. But my excitement comes from the beauty of what nature has done and what nature is constantly creating a change that artists may try to interpret, but it's virtually impossible. Here are pieces of wood that might have taken 200, 300, 400 years. And the turmoil and the subtleties, the quietness that happens with each changing day. And I think that's the excitement of the piece. And just as every stone has a story, every little piece of wood has so much to tell. And by adding the glass, it's kind of a contradiction to what man and nature are trying to create, some sort of harmony. But it's this connection that kind of excites me. And I like art that becomes not only interesting to look at and does something to the senses, but also becomes functional. So these works become fruit bowls. This particular piece excites me because of its minimalism. It has a very strong yin and yang feeling in its high contrast and also its contradiction within the piece itself. It really didn't need the glass, but again, being an artist, I felt I wanted to add something more to it in this connecting. And many of these pieces are really about connecting heaven and earth, which is the philosophy of all the art I do, whether it's environmental reclamation art, my paintings, or these found objects. This particular piece I found extremely busy. The wood had so many variations of textures and especially contrast in value. But what was also interesting, finding pieces of metal with the wood. And then I was doing little quick sketches of the area with markers, and so I did a small little drawing of Southern Oregon with the mountain in the background and some of the trees, and it was almost like a Zen quick matter of seconds the drawing was done. But in the case of this particular piece, it's the textural variations that excited me, and the negative space, the twisting and turning of the positives that created this interesting negative. It's a piece that I personally like looking into and through. And the whole idea of all of these pieces were to really pay attention to the little square centimeter of beauty, again, that nature has created. It's interesting about this piece is its bubbliness And I like this because even though it is tremendously textured with the lights and the darks, as you move around it, it is very simple and smoother. So the contrast of textures, I think, is fabulous on this particular piece. And of course, I didn't do it, nature did it. This particular piece, this massive lump, is, I think of it as almost a giant mouth. And the wonderful thing about this particular piece is when you put the fruit on the glass, it rolls down to the bottom. So I imagine if I were a child reaching down in the mouth for the fruit. And that again excites me. This particular piece I found to be almost spiritual. Because of my experiences in China with the gardens, the rock gardens, I really felt a kind of deep, rooted into the earth. And yet there was this piercing into the heaven. This piece became very spiritual for me, and in particular because embedded, as this tree and this root grew, it encompassed four rocks. So four rocks are embedded within this piece. These particular pieces with the flat wood, I cut, and I liked what was happening after the cut. And it was a lot of work to sand because I'm not a very good craftsperson. In fact, I'm probably one of the worst. But then I used a butcher's block type of stain, so that someone could use this particular piece also as a cheese block. And the reason I lifted the piece, because I felt the legs are again another element that takes not only the piece in the air, but it's a connection to the earth. And I like that. And of course, three is one of the magic numbers in many faiths. There is a particular thing that I like in these flat pieces, and that is the patterns that are created in a two-dimensional sense. All the other works are 3D, but these are like nature's paintings. And the most amazing thing you can feel in the flat pieces is the energy of how nature's patterns work. The interesting thing for me about this piece is its massiveness. And out of the massiveness comes the contrast of the metal. And really the essence of many of these pieces are about the fruit. That one piece of fruit is very precious. And one piece of fruit can be placed almost like on an altar. And all of the bowls are about that preciousness of fruit. And it doesn't, none of them hold a lot. It's this less can be best. The drawings are actually all natural, made of wood shavings from the actual pieces and mixed with Elmer's glue. And they're kind of very simple strokes. And the piercing is the charcoal. The pieces are all signed and dedicated to women. Whose husbands and sons have been killed in the logging fields in southern Oregon.